another Sunday, but a different spot. I hope you recognize where I am. You know, it's the kitchen of the church. So I try to take video of a different area of the church and make sure that you guys still remember, you know, how the building looks like, how everything looks like and all that. And one day we'll be back here and we'll worship together. But until then, we'll continue to use video to, you know, to stay in touch and also talk about a few things about God and praise God together. So to begin our program today, we're going to start with a prayer. The Heavenly Father, thank you for being our God, and that's beyond our imagination and what we can ever ask for. There are times that we think that you know, we are in deep trouble. We can never get out of you know, the situation. But Lord, we know that never once did you ever let us walk alone. You are always with us, and because of who you are, we find you know, strength and comfort and peace in the difficult time. Help us that, you know, keep our focus on you instead of all the things happening around us, including the troubles and difficulties. We know that a lot of us may be feeling a little weak, whether it's physically, spiritually, or even, you know, emotionally, being locked at home for extended time. But Lord, we know that you're with us and you are almighty. And today we're going to learn more about your attributes. And we ask that you bless our time here. Even though we won't be able to meet face to face, we have to meet remotely through the video. Lord, I know that you're going to bless our time together. And in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So, we'll continue our series on the attributes of God. And in previous weeks, we learned about God is everywhere, all the time, anytime. And then we also learned last week that he is almighty, full of all possible power. And he's there for you wherever you are. And he's more than able to protect you and also keep you safe. This week, we will talk about another attribute of God. And we will be reminded that God is compassionate. So we don't always talk about people being very compassionate, and we may not have heard of that term being used on us. So today we're gonna learn about that, and you know, with Jesus Christ himself as the example. So, but before that, we're gonna go to, we're gonna sing a song, we're gonna praise God together. It's you know, a little introduction to the song. It's called Never Once. It's one of my all-time favorites. It personally keep me going whenever, if there's a difficult time, help me and remind me that I'm not walking this path all by myself. So let's not only enjoy the song, but we sing the song and let that strengthen us through his word. Thank you.
Just how far we've come, knowing that for every step you were with us. Kneeling on this battleground, seeing just how much you've done, knowing every victory was your power in us. Scars and struggles on the way, but with joy can say, yes, our hearts can say. Battleground, thousand struggles on the way, but with joy our hearts can say, never once did we ever walk alone. Carried by your constant grace, held within your perfect peace. Never once, no, we never walk alone. Never once did we ever walk alone. Never once did you leave us on our own. You are faithful, God, you are faithful. Every step we are breathing in your grace. Evermore we'll be breathing out your praise. You are
today's scriptures reading is coming from Psalm 86, verse 15 through 17. But you, Lord, are a compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love and faithfulness. Turn to me and have mercy on me. Show your strength in behalf of your servant. Save me because I serve you just as my mother did. Give me a sign of your goodness, that my enemies may see it and be put to shame, for you, Lord, have helped me and comforted me.
Hey kids, how are you doing? Under the current circumstances, all of us have to stay home, you know, to make sure that we are helping each other to stay healthy. I've been working from home, as I told you in previous episode, and I know some of you have started online classes or video conferencing, and you're using online videos to conduct some of the activities. You know, nonetheless, we are feeling a little disconnected from the people that we used to have much closer interaction with, you know, people that we talk to, we spend time with or even play with. You know, I really hope that it doesn't make us think less of them or, you know, less of these people that we know, and of course of their needs as well. We want to still stay compassionate towards these people that we know and these people who have need. And today we will actually talk about an attribute of God. God is compassionate. Now, what is being compassionate? Being compassionate means we're caring about the needs of others, the feeling of the other people, feeling sorry for them, and doing something to help them go through the trouble. Today we're actually going to look at a very familiar story in the Bible where God showed compassion to people. It's the story of Jonah. And Jonah, as we know, is a prophet who is, you know, basically a messenger of God. And God used the prophet to carry his message to the people he wants them to listen to. So I hope you enjoy the video that I'm going to show you. It's $1 million production of the story of Jonah, and we'll come back and we'll spend a little more time do more discussion about what the Jonah story is about and also what compassion is. So enjoy.
Today, we're going to take a journey through the Bible to learn about Jonah and God's grace and how God is a God of second chances. Welcome to Bruh Moments from the Bible.
Thank you, Lord, for this meal.
Jonah.
Yes, Lord?
Go to Nineveh.
Nineveh who?
Nineveh.
Nineveh what?
Nineveh.
Ninja what?
Go to Nineveh.
Bruh.
They must turn from their wicked ways.
Lord, I can't go there. They're mean, they're nasty, they smelly, they stink. Lord, they stink, and they just terrible people. Don't you have any other prophets? What about Micah, Nahum, Abeka, Zephaniah, Haggai? Where they at, Lord? Where they at?
Instead of doing what God said,
I ain't fitted to do this.
Jonah got on a ship going to Tarshish, far away from Nineveh. The ship got caught in a terrible storm, and Jonah was in the bottom of the ship, fast asleep.
Wake up, mate!
Wake up, man!
What's going on?
Don't you see the storm?
Are you out here taking a snooze?
Come on, deck! We want to cast lots and see who brought this storm upon us.
Pray to your god.
Somebody's going overboard.
Okay.
So they brought Jonah up and cast lots, and the lot fell on him. Right. So the sailors asked Jonah if he was the cause of the storm.
Are you the cause of this storm?
Yes. My name is Jonah. I'm a prophet of the true living God. Kind of been running away from him, and the only way to end this storm is to throw me overboard.
Is that the only way?
Yes.
Somebody's gotta go.
Well, alrighty then.
Wait, hold up!
See ya!
Whoa. Wait, hey look, it's calm out here.
Everything's calm now.
Hey, Jonah, we're alright!
You alright down there?
Hey, guys, I'm alright.
Maybe we should bring her back up.
He's the reason we're in this mess.
I don't know, maybe it's God just wanting to baptize him.
Hey, what's that?
What's that over there?
Hey.
Oi!
Hey, Jonah, look out!
What?
Jonah!
Big old...
Oi!
Oh. Oh!
You see that?
Let's get out of here.
Hoist anchor!
Hoist anchor!
But God sent a big fish to swallow Jonah.
Lord, God, I'm sorry. Been here 3 days. I should have just went to Nineveh, Lord. Please, just get me out of here. I'll go to Nineveh. I repent. Bruh.
God spoke to the great big fish, and the big fish spat Jonah out on dry land.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All right, baby. Thank you.
Jonah, go to Nineveh now.
All right. I'll go. One for the team.
Oh. So Jonah obeyed God and finally went to Nineveh.
Repent! You repent! For God will destroy Nineveh in 40 days if you don't turn from your wicked ways.
Who are you? What are you talking about?
Who is this God that you serve?
The God I serve is the one true living God. The God that parted the Red Sea. The God that brought the Israelites out of Egypt. The God that destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah, like he's going to do here if you don't repent.
That God?
The living God.
Forgive us, Lord.
Have mercy, O God.
Forgive us, Lord.
Have mercy, O God.
So their king declared a fast to cry to God. God heard their prayers and accepted their prayers of repentance and decided to not to destroy Nineveh after all.
Lord, this is not what I expected. Where's the fire? Where's the brimstone? These people deserve to die. Why you gotta be so loving? Why you gotta be so kind? Why you gotta be so gracious, man? These people don't deserve it.
Are you supposed to be angry? I show grace to whom I show grace. I show mercy to whom I show mercy.
God reminded Jonah that he shows grace and loves and cares about all of his people. God is a God of second chances that he freely gives to everyone. Oh.
you enjoy the video, we're gonna dive into the story of Jonah, and I'll also give you some context of what Nineveh is about and why Jonah hated to go to Nineveh at all. So often when we look at the story of Jonah, we focus on Jonah himself and his attitude, his action. Even sometimes we debate whether that big fish is a whale. But today we're gonna look at it from a different angle. We're gonna put our emphasis on God's compassion to the people in Nineveh. So just to give you some background, Nineveh was the capital of Assyria. Assyria is basically Israel's long-standing enemy in the 8th century BC. It was founded around 1800 BC on the eastern bank of the river Tigris. And it was an early center of idol worshiping the goddess Ishtar. And Nineveh was one of the largest cities in the world at that very time, with a population of over 100,000 people. So it's not a small city. And now we're going to look at why Jonah refused to go to Nineveh. He basically thinks that the people at Nineveh, they're all evil people, and they are cruel and horrible. These are just, you know, a lot, they are all bad apples, basically. And they don't deserve anything, not anything at all. You know, especially the mercy and love of from God. He was so afraid that if he went there and told those people about the good news, you know, the gospel, you know, about God, they would repent and they become good and God would forgive them. He really wanted God to punish these evil people in Nineveh. However, God has a different idea. God sees it differently. He has compassion towards the people in Nineveh, even though he knows that these people are wicked, these people are really undeserving. And he wants to give these people a second chance. And at the end, the people of Nineveh listen to Jonah's message and give up their wicked behavior. They put on sackcloth and pray for forgiveness. And so God changes his mind, and God is not punishing the people in Nineveh. So again, compassionate means showing or having a deep concern for others and desire to meet their needs. Here God sees that these people, while they're wicked and undeserving, he knows that these people need God. That's why he is willing to give them a second chance and show his compassion, show them he really cares. He cares about them so much that he's sending Jonah to tell them about himself and tell them about the gospel, the good news, and these people need to repent. So sometimes we really see other people's need, but we see it, but we at the same time, we ignore it because we don't like those people, or we dislike them, like just how Jonah felt about people in Nineveh. But then I want you to consider this. Are we really any better than these people that we despise? And you know, think about it. God still loves all of us and shows his compassion to us when we are so undeserving, right? When we strive to imitate Christ, which is something the Bible tells us that we should do, we become people of compassion and mercy also. And when God shows us compassion, we can show our compassion to others as well. So I will illustrate this idea with with some props, and you're gonna see it in the next few video clips. God has shown us compassion. We can show our compassion to others too. And what I'm gonna show you is the ripple effect. What it means is when we start doing something to show compassion to others, whether it is a small thing or something big that you plan for, it doesn't really matter. What matters is you go do it and show people that there is a compassionate God and you are compassionate towards them. You understand their need, you try to help, you give them nice and encouraging words, you share resources to them, you say nice things to them, help them understand that there's a God, you help them by praying for them. These things will make a difference in someone's life. It's bring positive
effects to the people. And so it may be something small. You may think that it's just a drop into the water, but the ripple effect will spread out, and then, you know, it's going to do great things. So it has to start with you. So that will be one of the challenges that I give you for this week. So stay tuned.
So before we go, I want to give you a quick wrap up, and we're going to talk about a few points. First of all, in Psalm 86, verse 15, which is part of the scriptures reading we did today, it tells us that God has compassion for his people. The greatest example of God's compassion is the truth that Jesus came to the earth to die for all of us, and what he did on the cross in place of us, the sinners. And this week, I would like to give you three challenges. One, in the coming week, I want you to think about your needs and how the compassion of God meets your needs. And also, I want you to be thankful for it. All right, that's number one. Number two, how can you show compassion to the people around you or in the community? What are their needs and what can you do to meet their needs? How can you ask God to help you achieve that? So that is number two. Number three, I want you to do some research. Maybe you Google it, you look through your encyclopedia, or you can talk to your friends or whatever. What is the biggest fish still existing today? All right, do some research on it. And next week, right here, I'll show you the answer. And then we will, you know, in the next video. All right, so those are the three things. Until then, stay healthy, stay in touch, stay with God. All right, I'll see you next Sunday at 9:30 a.m. All right, bye.